I'm now joined by Dr. Jerry Corsi here. Now, Dr. Corsi, I don't know how much research you've done into this, and we can go down this road or we can go down a different road, but there is an individual, Bill Browder, who most people have probably never heard of. In fact, I know Russia's very aware of him. One of our producers was telling me about him 2 years ago, how we needed to report on him, but it kind of wasn't in the news, so I just kind of dropped the ball. But now, last week, Bill Browder's been doing his media campaign tour, Dr. Corsi. He's going on like five media outlets a day, telling the world how bad Putin is, telling the world how bad Trump is. So this is now another deep state operative, anti-nationalist operative, who's going vocal against Trump and Putin. Why? Well, I guess he's probably got something to hide of his own. What do you think, Jerry Corsi?
Well, very definitely he has something to hide on his own. He is the was an entrepreneur who, in the early part of 2000, went over to Russia and made about $1.5 billion, renounced his U.S. citizenship, didn't pay any U.S. taxes, managed to get out of the Soviet Union, gave part of his company, his Hermitage Capital, to HSBC, and then got involved in a money laundering scheme where he got the $1.5 billion out of Russia and didn't pay any Russian taxes. And then he came back to the United States periodically and is the force behind this Magnitsky Act, because Magnitsky was his attorney that the Russians said cheated them out of the $230 million in taxes and put him in prison. So it's a complicated story, but it's the story that Putin brought to the surface again in the Helsinki press conference by saying Browder engaged in all this fraud and contributed $400 million to Hillary Clinton, which nobody knew about.
Yeah, and it was amazing to me when Vladimir Putin said that, because, again, I'm somebody that kind of monitors media all day long, and you never really saw or heard of Bill Browder outside of some other independent news outlets and Russian media. You never really heard Bill Browder's name. And then I see him going on all the different TV networks telling everybody how bad Trump is, how bad Putin is, how Russia's this big problem, even though he left the United States to go to Russia. I mean, a total fraud. And then Putin says Bill Browder's name. He says George Soros' name. So this is why they hate Russia so much. This is why they hate Trump getting along with Putin, because Putin knows what's going on. I mean, say whatever you want about Putin. You know, he's not going to take this crap from George Soros and Bill Browder.
Well, and also now Putin has, you know, just dropped another bomb. They filed charges in Russia against Browder for, you know, going stealing all this money and not paying taxes. And also then they've filed charges against several U.S. Diplomats and others in the intelligence agencies, including this former. Let me just get the file here. I've been researching this extensively for the past week. This Michael McFaul, who is the U.S. ambassador, was U.S. ambassador to Russia in the period 2012 to 2014. And Russia is claiming that McFaul is one of the people who helped Browder steal the money out of Russia. And clearly with HSBC owning part of Browder's Heritage Capital, it would have been quite possible to use HSBC for the money laundering. It was at a time when Comey was on the
Yeah, I was going to say, and then doesn't that implicate a lot of more actors if that was the case?
Right. I mean, this is a serious case. I mean, this is a serious charge, because the Magnitsky case, it ties in several different ways. One, it was the case where we imposed some of the most severe sanctions on Russia, and that was really intensified the This is all in the Obama administration, intensified the tensions with Russia. And secondly, this whole issue of the Browder case comes up in this attorney, who the Russian attorney that was in there talking to Donald Trump Jr. She was in there talking all about his whole subject was to talk about Browder.
And she already had a prior relationship with Browder via Fusion GPS. And this was
Correct.
The lawyer that was essentially snuck in the country by the Obama administration. I mean, nobody really still can figure out how she got in the country other than the Obama administration signing her off. So that's what's going on.
Right.
Jerome Corsi is on top of all of this. Alex Jones is going to be joining us on the other side. to discuss Putin, who's calling it as it is, folks. I mean, again, say what you want about Vladimir Putin. The guy calls it as it is. You have to appreciate that. He says, forces in the United States are trying to undermine successful talks with Trump. They want war with Russia. They plan on war with Russia over Syria. They're not getting their war. It's ticking them off. So we're trying to tie all these geopolitical strings together here. Kit Daniels had a story last year. Putin says Hillary behind Russian collusion hysteria and elites disrespect Trump voters. And in this story, he mentioned some of this collusion and then the names like Bill Browder that are now becoming mainstream. But here's the story. And I want to get Dr. Corsi's take on this in response. So let's just look at Putin for a second. Let's flash the clocks back 2 years when there were uprisings and violent protests in Kiev and in Crimea in the Ukraine, where you had unidentified snipers shooting protesters, and then the media blamed Putin for that. And so Putin doesn't respond to the fake news anymore. He genuinely doesn't care. And so to the fake news, they think that means he's guilty, when the truth is he just doesn't care. He doesn't bother to sling mud with the fake news. Then it comes out a year later that the snipers were actually Ukrainian paid for Georgian snipers that were there to false flag it and blame Putin. So it all came out. This is what they do with their false flags. And Putin has never really provided them any fuel. He just ignores it. And so they take that and they say, oh, Putin must be guilty. He's ignoring it. No, Putin is just ignoring your fake news. So anyway, this is how they demonize Putin, when all Putin's doing, honestly, is calling out the bad actors here. And we know what Soros does. We know Soros has involvement in the struggle with Ukraine and Russia, where the Crimean people want to be a part of Russia, but then they fund these violent protests, say that Crimea doesn't want to be part of Russia, and then people get shot and they blame Putin, just twisting and concocting the whole thing. And you know people like Soros are involved in this. Who knows what Bill Browder's doing with his billions of dollars tax-free? But what do you make of the hysteria that continues in the media over Trump, Putin, over Russia? I mean, these people really want war with Russia, Dr. Corsi.
Well, I also think there's an element here of the deep state realizing how close Donald Trump is to really exposing and showing the corruption within the deep state and shutting down Mueller's operation. I mean, Mueller's indictment here, these 22 or now 12 intelligence agencies, plus the other 13 individuals named in the first indictment, none of them are going to come to the United States to face trial. And what Putin has done is he's called the bluff. He said, well, send your FBI or whatever to Russia, and you can interview the indicted 12 intelligence agents in Russia. And then he also countered with this suit charging Browder with crimes in Russia. And Browder appears to be protected by the former U.S. ambassador to Russia, Michael McFaul. And as I've researched Michael McFaul, Putin's got a lot of reason to be angry at him. In 2012, McFaul went over to Russia and started undermining Putin. He started having meetings with the various opposition to Putin in order to see if he could destabilize the election and let Putin lose. Now, Putin understands that at the heart of what he's just done with this indictment is to expose that the United States was deeply involved in meddling in his election in 2012. And this McFaul is at the heart of it, probably involved in a criminal scheme with this guy Browder, and maybe that involves U.S. money laundering through HSBC when James Comey was on the board of HSBC and Robert Mueller was head of the FBI. So, I mean, Putin is, I think, quite clever. And I think he's really put on the table something that's going to take Americans a little bit of time to understand. But I've been trying to explain this, that it's a very brilliant move by Putin.
Well, here's the thing about Putin, too. Like, again, there's all of these different false images of who Putin really is. You know, he's this strong man dictator, this, that, and the other thing. Putin, honestly, I mean, if you really want to know Putin, Putin is there 100% to protect Russia. That is his number one thing. He wants to maintain Russia as an independent sovereign nation. And that's really when where his if you want to call him a dictator, stops. This these people don't even understand the geopolitics. Half of the country is going to bed when the other half is waking up. So St. Petersburg is at bedtime when Moscow is getting up in the morning. You think Putin is a dictator over this country that makes up 30% of the world's landmass, 11 different time zones? They don't even have a clue what they're talking about. He's just trying to maintain Russia as an independent sovereign nation and just keep them together. That's all he cares about. He doesn't care about the fake news. But Dr. Corsi, why do you think, I mean, here's my take. I think Bill Browder is panicking right now. I'm not sure exactly why. Maybe Trump knows something. Maybe Putin knows something. But this is a guy who you never saw on TV, barely ever heard of. Now he's doing like five interviews a day across all television stations. So why do you think Bill Browder is all of a sudden out in public crying Putin, Trump bad?
Well, see, I think, first of all, what Putin realizes, and I think Donald Trump does as well, is that they are both under attack by the deep state. The deep state would like to destabilize both of them. The hard left deep state is still angry that Russia gave up communism, and they'd like to get rid of Putin and reinstate communism in Russia. The same way here, Donald Trump stood in the way of Hillary Clinton, you know, taking the hard left Democratic Party and making us first socialists and then communists of the same move. And Donald Trump and Putin are standing in the way. Now, this indictment with Browder, with the connection to $400 million to Hillary, is a very clever, I think, move that will ultimately could bring Mueller down. Because Mueller's been challenged. If you have this, if you've got an indictment against 12 Russians, come over here to Russia and we'll help you investigate them. You know, Christopher Ray is never going to do
like,
that.
Just like the original indictments with the I think it's like 13 Russians and three Russian entities, so said, they have legal representation show up in court and demand discovery. Mueller balks. I mean, it's the same thing. Russia's like, all right, you know, we're here, we'll cooperate, and then Mueller walks away.
Well, see, Mueller never intended to bring these cases to court. I mean, look what's happened. The Russian collusion couldn't be proved, so now, like, you know, global warming, it morphed into climate change.
Exactly.
Well, now we've got, instead of Russian collusion, we've just got Russian involvement in our election, which, by the way, has been going on for a long time. And Russia's countering and saying, you were involved in my election.
And they even admit there was no impact.
Your ambassador, right, and no impact. But see, again, what Donald Trump's got to say and understand to the American people is that this proves there's no collusion, because that whole argument is abandoned and lost in the shift to the focus on Russian involvement in the election. If they prove Russian involvement in the election, that does nothing to harm Donald Trump, because he didn't encourage the Russian
and
involvement.
And it was the Obama administration that allowed it, literally.
Correct.
And they admit it. I mean, it's so crazy, but that, I don't know. I guess I should stop being shocked. I know I live in 1984 society, so I guess I should just expect this stuff. Up is down, down is up, war is peace, and truth is fiction. This is 1984 society, brought to you by the left. Well, you just heard Alex break it all down. I just want to get your response to that and all of your research that you've done into the deep state that you see Trump is fighting against.
Well, as usual, I think Alex is exactly right. I mean, this is a... clearly, the United States and Russia, as two nation states, won't see every issue eye to eye. We have our own nation state interests. Russia has theirs. You know, Ukraine is an example. Within their sphere of influence, you know, going back to the balance of power theories of 200 or 300 years ago that, you know, that have persisted since then, we're probably not going to go to war over Ukraine, and Russia's probably not going to go to war over something that happens in, you know, Cuba. I mean, that was, we went through that whole issue in the 60s, and we found out that basically, you know, the Western Hemisphere is going to be U.S. sphere of influence, and Russia is going to have theirs. But the point is, right now, it is a fight to the death with the deep state for both Putin and for Trump. And when they got together in their meeting privately, I'm sure they exchanged notes and realized that they were each dealing with the same enemy. This is why I think Putin has come out brilliantly and said to Mueller, if you really have a case here, if you really wanted to go to trial, or it was just show trial, if this is all just, you know, you want to say you indicted people, therefore you proved your case, Putin said, you didn't prove anything. Come to Russia, and I'll let you investigate the 12 intelligence agents you thought you indicted.
And you have these just frankly dumb you-know-what people say, hey, where's your evidence of Russian collusion? And they say, oh, there's indictments. That's not evidence. They don't even understand it.
And I heard one of the congressmen during the hearing, you know, which Representative Deutsch was calling for InfoWars to be banned from Facebook. Another one of the Democrats said that this indictment proved that Putin stole the election.
It proves nothing.
It proves that he indicted some people. Well, okay, now prove your case, Mueller.
It's like they old saying, they can indict a ham sandwich.
And Mueller made these indictments knowing that there would never be a trial. He was shocked when one of the companies in the first indictment got some lawyers and said, we're going to defend the case. Mueller wasn't ready to go to trial because he never expected to go to trial. There is no case here. There's first of all, no collusion. So the Democrats have now morphed it into talking about Russian interference. And Rosenstein admitted the interference that the Russians have done was minimal and didn't affect the
outcome. Obama stood down. Obama said, stand down. Dr. Corsi, do you have a ham sandwich in your refrigerator?
Maybe I can go indict it.
Well, you might want to watch out because Mueller might be on his way to indict your ham sandwich. So you might want to get rid of that evidence, but then he'll indict you for obstruction of justice. All right, Dr. Corsi, thank you so much for joining us. Find him on Twitter @Jerome_Corsi.